remember how we felt when we first arrived?
Of course I can. But it was different then.
Sarah, we've been over all this.
But this is what you and Dad have always wanted. So why, the moment he's not here, are we selling Silverdale?
Because we can't run the place without him.
How do we know? We haven't tried.
What are you talking about? I've been working my fingers to the bone for the last 6 weeks.
I think I'll just go and check on the animals.
Matt, you don't have...
Doesn't anyone care about what Dad would have wanted?
Of course we do, Sarah. But we can't cope. Your dad wouldn't want us swimming against the tide.
Oh, wake up, Sarah. You're not exactly around to help. You've already lined up a tutoring job. Come September, you'll be back at university and it'll just be Mum, me and Molly.
Marcus, don't.
All right, it's get Sarah time, is it?
No, we're just being realistic. We can't afford to pay anybody. We're only keeping our heads above water because Matt and Bella are helping us out. Do you really think Mum and I want to do this?
Then don't. What happened to fighting for what you wanted? I mean, who said this was going to be easy? Dad left us Silverdale. We should do everything we can to keep it.
Sarah, if there was any other option, we wouldn't be doing it.
This is our home, Mum. Where are we going to go?
We'll make that decision once we've sold the house.
Oh, so we're just leaving Dad behind, aren't we? We bury his ashes, then disappear, never to return.
He wanted to be here.
And we're not going to be with him. Well, Moll doesn't want to go. I don't want to go. Only you and Marcus do. Since when were your two votes better than ours?
Teenagers,
probably kissing.
Like a bomb.
Hey, take it!
How about this then, Vicar?
I don't understand to do something like this.
Young vandals. Without any direction, any purpose, they've got it all too easy.
Excuse me, I'd better get the girls to bed.
Skateboards, televisions, computers. In my day, we were doing our national service. I don't know what's going on with the kids these days. I really don't.
Mrs. Addis?
She's hungry. This is the best place to see everything?
Well, I'm not moving. There's only one thing for it.
I do know the value of a good view, Mrs. Addis.
You haven't mentioned the business?
No. I've prepared two sets of details. One for those interested in the property with the business as a going concern, and the other for those buyers more interested in Silverdale for its domestic potential. It really is a great view.
Sorry, I'm not very fluent in estate agent. What do you mean by domestic potential?
Well, with the problems in farming, most of the property is attracting people who want to put the land to other use. What we need is a photograph of that.
Other than what? Brian's business?
Yes, could be.
Let's get something straight, Mr. Roebuck. I am only selling Silverdale to someone who wants to carry on the business. Brian and I put everything we have into this place, and I am not going to stand by and let someone destroy it. Do I make myself clear?
So, where is it you're off to then? Australia?
Yes. Brian booked holiday for the whole family before he... Bill Thompson's going to be looking after the place while we're away, so you'll have to sort out any viewings with him. Molly!
Where is she?
Molly!
We can just ask her one of the days.
Molly!
I was listening to that.
This is Sarah. She's come to give you some extra help with your GCSEs.
Oh, Mum.
Nice to meet you.
He is 15. He's very good at it.
You still okay about me going back tomorrow? It's just I'm up for this promotion, eh?
Matt, we've kept you too long as it is. You've got a job and a family, and we're very grateful for all the help you've given us.
Yeah, it was the least I could do. Brian wasn't just a cousin, he was... he was more of a mate.
Don't forget to thank Frankie for us. Can't be easy lending out your husband.
She felt she needed time to get to know the kids without me being around. By now, she'll have discovered the joys of being woken at 5 by a 6-year-old and his dinosaur collection. You haven't lived till you've had a stegosaurus shoved up your nose.
You're a lucky man, Matt Brewer. Not many people would be happy about being left with someone else's kids.
By the time I get back, it'll be Dad who?
Oh, come on, Becky. Help me out here. It's not easy trying to find something that you'd all like to do. I didn't know it was going to be postponed. If I had done, we wouldn't have come all this way, would we? Nothing we can do about now, so why don't you just accept that and enjoy the rest of the day with us, eh?
I've got better things to do.
Such as?
I don't know, hang about with my mates or something. Anything's better than this.
Dad said we had to do what Frank told us.
Shut up, dweeb. I'm not a kid. All right, fine. We'll see you later, then.
What?
Well, the station's only a couple of miles away. Shouldn't take you long to walk. Sam! Coming to get you, ready or not. What's wrong, Luce? I thought that cake was your favourite.
Doesn't taste right.
Oh, no. Oh, what's wrong with it?
My mum used to put chocolate buttons on it.
Right, well, I will remember that for next time. Bet Mum was a really good cook, wasn't she?
Much better than you.
All right, fine. Well, if no one's hungry, why don't we head down to the safari park? Yeah? See if the baboons want to add our windscreen wipers to the collection.
Order, order! From the day the playground opened, there's been nothing but trouble. It's acted like a magnet to wanton vandalism. Therefore, we have decided not to waste valuable funds by replacing it.
Excuse me. Have you ever used the playground?
Well, no, of course not.
No? So it probably doesn't matter as much to you as it does to the children of this village. I mean, they haven't done this. Why are you punishing them?
Yes, Vicar.
May I make a suggestion, Chairman? The proceeds from this year's village fete could go towards repairing it.
That is hardly a helpful remark, Vicar. Those funds have been earmarked for the church organ fund. I thought you would have known that.
Yes, but perhaps the organ could wait till next year. How about we take a vote on it?
I'm not sure that this is a properly constituted meeting and should be taken as binding in any way.
Rubbish!
All right. All those in favour of allocating the proceeds from this year's fete to rebuild the playground, raise your hands. Those against?
I've got children, haven't I?
Meeting adjourned. Thank you. Let me make myself very clear. My land will only be available for the fete if the proceeds go to a charity that I support. Good night.
But, Mr. Bailey, surely the playground... No playground, now no fete.
We could have the fete on our land, couldn't we, Mum?
I don't think so, Mole. We'd be flying to the other side of the world on that day.
We'd leave it spotless. Promise you, you'd never know we'd been there.
I'd love to help, Tim, but...
Shame. They get right up Bob Bailey's nose, too.
Well, if you put it like that...
Never see this in London. Too many lights.
So my dad loved it. I just can't understand how Mum can leave all this.
Have you ever been in love?
I think so.
Then you'll know how painful it is when all that ends. And throw in the fact that there was no argument, no row, no breakup. Just a huge rug pulled from underneath you. That says, you're on your own now. Well, that's how I felt when my first wife, Marie, died. That's what your mum's feeling right now. And you can drown in that feeling if you don't take hold of your life and say, OK, but I have to live now. And that goes for you, as well as for Faith.
I think that so much.
Because she loved you, Dad.
Hello, monkey. Marcus, thank you. Good luck.
Cheers, Matt. Thanks for everything.
Just have a really good time in Australia.
I will.
See you guys.
Silverdale. What? When? It's 8:30 now. We agreed you'd give me plenty of notice. Yep, yep, okay.
To the
bedroom. Oh, great.
They're here.
I'll put them off.
No, Mum. I don't know how to get rid of cockroaches.
Molly, you. Sorry about that. Oh, fire.
You stink.
Morning, Molly. Morning, Faith. Is that right? I hear you carved up Bob Bailey last night. Good for you. Package for Sarah. From someplace very exotic.
Oh, Ghana. It's from the kids I taught. I can't believe they're still writing to me. Look. Look at that. It all seems so long ago. I miss it so much.
We have the raised beds. Oh, sweet! Rubber pony! What's the water supply like? Good enough for a swimming pool.
Excellent.
Am I not making myself clear, Mr. Roebuck?
I know that, Mrs. Addis, but...
Only people interested in running Silverdale as a business.
It really is a very generous offer.
I don't care what she's offering.
I'm not selling to her. But you really should consider Mrs. Webster's offer.
She's a cash buyer with no chain... And she can move immediately.
The answer is still no.
No to what?
This is Webster's offer on the house. The full asking price. I am right, aren't I?
Just think what Dad would have said about her. And there's your answer.
It's on the syllabus, Ron, and we don't have a choice.
Poetry's boring, though.
Is it?
Yeah, I mean... Who cares what a sparrow looks like? It's a sparrow. Poets just go on and on about absolutely nothing.
So you've not read Wilfred Owen?
And unless he does the inside of birthday cards, no, I can't say I have.
OK. Imagine you're 2 years older and war is declared. So you sign up.
You lie about your age. It's not uncommon. Thousands of other boys are doing just the same. They give you a uniform, a rifle, a bayonet, and send you to France. On your first day, you see all of your brothers, your friends, your comrades, slaughtered in front of your eyes for the futility of trying to gain 10 yards. And behind them is another group of excited young men, about to take their place and die in exactly the same way. Millions of them. Wilfred owns all this. He sent these men out to die and hated every minute of it. All the while writing down his anger in poetry, only to die days before peace was declared. But if you're not interested in that...
No, that sounds cool.
One thing our female readers will be keen to know. Comment vous trouvez les femmes anglaises?
You speak French. No, you are ladies full of surprises.
Well, just because I work for a tabloid doesn't mean to say I didn't have an expensive education. I wouldn't underestimate me, Monsieur Falaise.
I don't intend to, mademoiselle. Ah, Marcus!
Oi.
Marcus, I told that imbecile to deal with you.
Do what?
Mademoiselle will excuse me. We have a problem with his courgette. I have to go and inspect his camion de zucchini. Marcus, viens ici. I thought our secret was safe.
What are you talking about, Cliff?
Come here. That woman there, she's a journalist. Now, normally it's all lifestyle stuff, but she's getting a bit too personal. She has come down here to turn me over, and the only person who knows Laurent Falaise is a sham is you.
Well, she didn't get it from me. Anyway, how long do you think you can let this ridiculous girl carry on?
Look, people like a bit of Gallic charm. It got me backers, it got me publishers, the whole celebrity chef thing. And the last thing I need now is some headline saying French fraud for Les is really Castleford Cliff. I'd be ruined.
So what are you going to do? Look at this place. You made this. Aren't you proud to be who you are? Or are you going to rely on people like me lying for you for the rest of your life?
No, Marcus, wait.
Well, if it isn't Courgette Boy and his infamous sidekick, Laurent.
Yes, well, Laurent has got something he wants to tell you.
Hey, not for you.
Mr. Rogers, five daddies.
I've just been doing the chickens.
That makes two of us. We've got 18 acres here. We grow 32 varieties of veg and herbs. We sell to locals, hotels, restaurants.
Not bad.
We do on average 120 boxes a week.
Is that right?
I'll be totally honest with you, Mr. Rogers. My husband died in an accident 6 weeks ago. His ashes are buried underneath this cherry tree. I'm only selling because we found it too hard to manage without him. I love this place. And everything we've achieved here. So you'll understand why it's so important that I sell to someone who'll carry on what we've started off.
I gotta go home and do a few sums. But from what I've seen, I'll be putting in an offer first thing tomorrow.
Do you mean that?
And don't worry about the old man. He can stay there as long as he wants.
Oh, Mr. Rogers, I could kiss you.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't if I were you. I know where I've been.
Bell?
I don't know. 1 minute I was up there, and now I'm down here. I went over on my ankle.
You all right?
Don't worry about me. I'll be all right. The grain seemed to give way beneath my feet.
I'm pretty sure it's just a bad sprain.
I'll be as right as rain.
You'll have to rest it, Bill. And I need to find someone else to look after this place while we're away.
You all right, Mum?
Mac's going away, so she can't do it. I've tried everyone else I can think of.
We'll be able to go.
Do you think Matt will come back and look after the place for us?
No. He's going for this new job. I can't ask him to take any more time off his holiday. No, I'm just going to have to try and think of someone else.
Hi, is Mrs. Davis inside? Sarah. Is everything all right?
Yeah, fine, thanks.
Look, this is silly. I really should have told you before, but he hates people knowing. Ronan's got leukemia.
I'm sorry, Celeste, but property to rent around here is hard to come by.
Thanks anyway.
And I'll let you know if anything comes up. Bye.
BSc in agriculture. Can you tell me how much the fees are? What about the part-time course?
That's 1800.
Okay. Right, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Who do they only want? Lottery winners?
Estate agents. Whoever invented them should be shot. Buying is well above us, Marcus. I don't suppose you fancy living with my mum.
Oh, are things ever going to go our way?
This'll cheer you up. I saw Mac this morning. She gave me the wedding film from the processors. I think she's been holding it back until she thought we were ready.
Oh, I'd love to. But there's so much of Dad on this. I don't think we could put Mum through that.
Do you think it's wrong of me to have so many happy memories of that day? After what happened to your dad?
It was our wedding day, Celeste. It will always be the happiest day of my life. I said it then, and I still mean it.
You want to know what you got?
Probably a C minus on the red blood cell count and a D plus on the white. I could always do better. I'm sorry, A is usually followed by complete waste of time.
Not today.
I got an A.
Matt. Welcome back. Good of you to come in for a chat.
You know why we wanted to talk to you?
Yes, I got the letter. Yeah.
Good. Take a seat.
Right. Nice time.
Thanks.
So, you've been with the company for how long now?
12 years. I was made head nurseryman after two.
Must have seen a lot of changes in your time.
Well, I'm not afraid of change, if that's what you mean.
Good. The manager will be responsible for 20 staff.
I could cope with that.
I don't want him to feel he's being compromised by what he's inheriting. Do you understand what I'm saying?
I'm not sure that I do.
He should have a completely fresh hand to play with, not feel he's inheriting dead wood.
Oh, I don't think that would be a problem. I mean, all the staff here are excellent.
Yes. But we're going to have to juggle things around. Now, we currently employ 8 people on the nursery side and 16 in retail. That's a total of 24. So it's up to Josh to decide who he wants on his team.
Josh?
Josh is the new manager. We appointed him when you were away. We'd like you to reapply for one of the nursery jobs.
Thank you.
is chair of Mallingham Squash Club. I kid you not, my friend. Matt,
just where exactly do you get off calling me in here and taking my job away from me? I've been working for this company for a back-breaking 12 years. If you think you can get rid of me that easy, well, think again.
Now, listen, Matt.
12 years at a month's salary a year. That's how much it's going to cost you to make me redundant. There's no way I'm reapplying for a job that I left behind 10 years ago. And if you think you can run the company by treating people like this, you're about to find out what a bloody disaster it is. Nice try.
How much?
He wants an answer by the end of the day.
He's seen another place he likes, but he thinks your soil is better.
And to top it all, Mrs. Webster is
desperate to buy your property. She got wind of Mr. Rogers' interest and has increased her offer to £10,000 above the asking price.
And before you say anything, Mrs. Addis,
I strongly recommend you consider her offer seriously.
Thank you, Mr. Roebuck.
I really need to speak to my wife.
Matt?
Please, Frankie, 2 minutes. This could change our lives.
Sorry, can you just excuse me? 2 minutes.
Thank you.
The most amazing thing has just happened to me.
Have you got the job?
I got the sack.
You've got the sack?
I got the sack, but do you know what's even funnier than that?
That is not funny, Matt.
I've got myself a new job. Well, I might have, if you agree. Silverdale. Faith selling the house, the business, the whole shebang. I mean, I thought our lives were here in London, but... I mean, think about it. Are they? Could we?
Are they, could we what?
Are our lives still in London? Could we buy the business?
Us?
Yeah, what do you say?
What do you expect me to say?
I want you to say yes. Well?
Matt, I can't think. I don't understand. What has happened to your... Will you just please answer the phone?
I want to hear what you say.
Hello? Sorry, hang on. It's the police.
Hello?
Rebecca's goods was negligible. Nail varnish at £195. We do know a couple of the other girls, though. It's not the first time they've been in trouble. Now, my advice to you, Rebecca, is make new friends. We spoke to the store, and they say, considering the value of the goods stolen, and bearing in mind that Rebecca's not been in trouble before, they are prepared this time not to press charges. Let her off with a warning.
What were you thinking of?
I don't know.
Thank you, Sergeant. Becky?
Yeah, thank you, Sergeant.
I know Becky won't let you down.
What's this about, Mum?
We've had two serious offers on the house.
Well, not that Mrs. Webster again.
Uh-huh. She's offered us £10,000 above the asking price.
Who's the other offer from?
Mr. Rogers.
No contest.
He's offered us 30,000 below the asking price.
Frankie, it'd be great for us. I know it. We both loved Brian and Faye's place when we saw it, remember? Well, all that could be ours. It'd give us our own business. Think about it. Yours and mine. No bosses to answer to, just you and me.
No to Mrs. Webster. She'd destroy this place before we were out the drive.
I agree. Me too.
Then we sell to Mr. Rogers. I think he's exactly what we're looking for.
But he's ripping us off. He knows this place is worth more than that.
Maybe Roebuck's right. If we want to sell it as a business, then, well, maybe we've got to face the fact that not many smallholders are going to have the kind of money that Mrs. Webster has.
We should stick to our principles. We want someone who will carry on the business, so we take the financial consequences.
And it'd be so good for the kids. We could get Becky away from the girls she's been mixed up with, and just imagine how much Sam and Lucy would enjoy. All that space to play in, and the animals. It's the kind of life you dream about giving your kids. And we can.
£30,000 is a lot of money. Dad put everything into Silverdale. We can't undersell it.
So if you won't take Mr. Rogers' offer, are you saying we can stay here?
We've been over this. We can't manage. We'll go bust and have nothing left to sell.
Then we have to take his offer, don't we?
We need a fresh start, Frankie. I know how hard it's been for you living here in the place that me and Marie bought. We need our own home. And Silverdale, it just feels right. You know, you're my inspiration for wanting to do this. What do you say, Frankie?
You've got a nerve, Matthew Brewer. You're asking me to give up everything that I know and move 200 miles away to live in the middle of nowhere? To do what? I won't have a job, no friends. I don't know anything about the countryside. I think I'm probably allergic to pigs. I love you, innit?
Is that a yes?
We're not selling to that man.
You're just contradicting yourself. One minute we can't cope, the next we can. So if we can hang on till we can find the right buyer, why can't we hang on forever?
Because if Marcus doesn't have a nervous breakdown, I will. All this arguing, it isn't making it any easier for me, you know.
I don't think we should sell Silverdale. It was meant for us, and that's why we found it.
No, Mole. But isn't it better to sell it to someone who cares?
So, are we going with Mr. Rogers or not?
Not.
So you're admitting it? We don't need to sell at all?
Oh, not now.
You're twisting my words.
I'm not. You're the one that says we have to sell.
To the right person at the right price.
Face it, Marcus, there never will be the perfect buyer.
Well, what do you suggest we do?
Oh, hi, Matt.
Is Silverdale still for sale?
Yeah, why?
Because me and Frankie would like to buy it.
We could offer you the full asking price.
You're joking.
I've never been more serious. But there is one other thing.
And I'm really sorry for asking you this, but we really need to move quickly. You see,
now we've sold this place, we need to settle the kids before they go back to school.
That shouldn't be a problem at all, Matt. In fact, you've just solved two problems in one.
indio, mi colomingio. Casi ma camboyamo che li ene che li ombeca. Come chi non ma cacciamo una.
Hello, love.
Hello.
Okay.
I think I've been so against selling Silverdale because I was scared of where my life was heading. I want to quit university. I chose the wrong course.
You've worked so hard to get there, love. Don't you think you should give it a second chance?
Recently, things have made me realise you should do what makes you happy because you never know how long you have.
Yeah, I know. Doesn't your education matter to you?
Oh, of course it does. But Mum, I've decided. I want to teach.
I was wondering how long it'd take to work that one out.
I want to sell me
outside! Run.
I want to sell me outside!
No going back.
Won't be as easy for Faith to leave Silverdale.
Yeah, but I was thinking, why don't we try and do something special for him?
No.
Just
had your
breakfast.
Who wants to go to Devon then?
Me!
Cheer up, Bex. Right, wave bye-bye, house.
Bye-bye, house.
That's it. Bye-bye, wheelie bin.
Bye-bye,
wheelie bin. Off we go then. Sure you're okay about this, Mum, because we can do it another time.
I think this is exactly the right time, don't you? Draw the curtains, please, girls. Right. All right, Mum.
That's my hat.
Oh dear. Oh, Nanny's toasting you early. Oh!
Last of cupcakes.
Cupcakes.
Oh, cupcakes. Can I turn it off, Mum?
Dad always agreed that we should give you all freedom. Give you the chance to learn from your mistakes. Find your own way. Now that we're all moving on, I think it's the right time to give you these presents from me and your dad. Sarah, this is for you. Marcus. And Celeste.
An air ticket from Sydney to Ghana. Oh, God, Mum, thanks.
Dear Mr. Edis, we have the pleasure of confirming your place at Dart Agricultural College.
And before you ask, the fees have been paid. Les, Tim told me about a church cottage that was for rent, so I put down a deposit.
Thank you, Faith.
This is for you, madam.
Thanks, ma'am. That's not fair. All I get is homework and they all get presents.
Well, in a way, yes, but I thought we could extend our holiday. Travel a bit, you know, until we decide where we're going to live. Unfortunately, I'll have to take you out of school.
Oh.
But then I am a teacher, so I can teach you myself.
It's not fair.
Hiya. How many removal vans do you lot need? It's like a circus out there.
Yeah, sorry
about that. Hi, guys.
Oh, yeah. Hi. What is it?
Come out here, I'll tell you. Actually, sorry, there was one thing we forgot to mention.
Telling me next that the Red Arrows are doing a fly pass.
This is all you're doing. I want you to accept full responsibility.
Can't blame me.
No, no. Was... have a look.
But one thing you cannot deny about this phony Frenchman is that the proof of the pudding is in the eating. Cliff Lawrence is one hell of a chef.
L'orphan is Emma.
Long live Cliff Lawrence! Hey!
Things are swinging. Birds are singing. And just what do you think those bells are doing but ringing? Cause they have to ring to make this whole thing rhyme. And you know that things are swinging all the time. If the news is what the blues is, then we'd better just practice up on our ones and twos.
See, this is a good burger. It's not just the quality of the meat, the magic. Lies in the onion.
Hey, listen, you couldn't help me and Frankie out, could you? It's just we didn't know what to do for Faith, didn't we?
Yeah, all right. Joe, yeah, take over, will you? So
keep going. Feel it, Mom. Ladies and gentlemen, and boys and girls, would you all gather round? I'd just like to make a quick announcement. That's it. All come over here, sit close as you can. That's lovely. Plenty of room down here. Don't be afraid, I'm not going to take your money. Actually, I am going to take your money, that's a lie. Okay, good. I'd like to propose a vote of thanks to Faith and her family for letting us use their land. In doing so, all the money raised today will go towards rebuilding the children's playground. But today is also the day that we say goodbye. You go with our love and our thanks for being in our lives. So, three cheers for the Addis family. Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
Hip hip!
Hooray!
All right, goodbyes. Where's the taxi? It should have been here 10 minutes ago.
I cancelled it.
Matt, we've got a plane to catch. We'll be late to check in.
Don't worry, your luggage is on the way to the airport.
How are we going to get there?
Carriage away.
Things are swinging, birds are singing, and just what do you think those bells are doing but ringing? Cause they have to ring. bring to make this whole thing rhyme. And you know that things are swinging all the time. Like an ocean that's in motion, like the wind that's blowing a boat riding the shore. It's the livingest thing to live and breathe.
How many of those has he got?
He hasn't got any. Things are swinging.
Yes, life? Things are swinging and they keep swinging some more. Let's keep on swinging and swing right out the door.
Think now, I've got two ponies, two pigs, got some chickens.
How many?
We'll have to go and count them later if you want. That's where we've got tomatoes in here.
Pinch me, are we really here?
No regrets.
You kidding?
Mum?
Yes, Sam?
The goats really like our lettuces.
Like an ocean.
Oh!
That's in motion. Like the wind that's blowing up the boat right in the shore. It's the livingest thing to live and breathe and keep on having all the swing. Things are swinging and they'll keep swinging some more. Yes, things are swinging and they'll keep swinging some more. Let's keep on swinging and swing right out the door.